Hello, my name is Lucas, this is A Bit of Lit, and I'm here a week late to talk about the first 8 chapters of Sanctuary by William Faulkner for Faulkner in August 2021. I was invited last week when everybody was posting about these chapters. I was invited by Brian at Bookish, and wanted me to join in on the fun. I had been away from BookTube for a while, and now I'm back after my hiatus, and after I returned and my channel was deleted, which was terrifying, but I made the appeal, and YouTube saw that I did not violate any of the terms of service, so thank you. I'm glad to be back again. Yeah, so I was invited to join in on the fun. Now, my idea of a good time and fun is not reading William Faulkner, but I digress. That is not to say I have not enjoyed his works before. I've certainly enjoyed Go Down Moses last year, and I also really enjoyed Absalom last year. And I've read Barn Burning and A Rose for Emily. These short stories are very good, I think. However, William Faulkner is unreadable because of his writing style. Now, he's very good with his characters, in my opinion. I think he has really complex, motivated characters that can be sympathetic, but also hard to, like, you just want to see him suffer sometimes, even though you don't really want to see anybody suffer. Sometimes they're that bad, but then they're also sympathetic in some strange ways, and also very at odds with themselves and with others, and for ways that make sense and feel meaningful to them. I think that's by far his best attribute when it comes to writing. His plots, from what I've read, are good. Not anything super special to me, but they make sense, and the characters and how they interact and go through these events feel like what would happen, I guess. I don't know how else to say it. They're perfectly fine to me. But the prose can be literally unreadable. The themes, again, these are okay. I don't know. When I read his books, I think, like, this is a very white perspective on racism in the South, and I just feel like not something that needs to be ignored or should be ignored, I guess, but he does have some things to say for helping understand racism in the South, I suppose. But I also think there are other books to read that can deal with that subject, that might give a better picture of the realities of racism. Not so much from, anyway, Sanctuary is an interesting book. It's probably the easiest novel of his I've read so far. I have my own issues with it. I feel like the prose, the writing style, is not so confusing as it is in the other two books that I've read. Oh my god, I'm having flashbacks to the bear. Good lord. Terrifying. Also, I mean, both of those books were just, I basically read them 2 or 3 times in the process of reading them. This one I'm reading about one and a half times. Sometimes I'm like, wait, what's going on? I think actually, like, in these first eight chapters, we're introduced to a lot of really low down, dirty, ruined people who are around this ruinous farmland. We've got this man trying to make his way to Jefferson. We've got these young people, Temple and what's his first name? What's his first name? Something with a G. Stevens is his last name anyway. And then these bootleggers. Not a lot of good things have happened. Actually, no good things have happened so far in the first eight chapters. I have a strong, foreboding sense of horror as I'm reading it. As Stevens, this alcoholic, set during the time of Prohibition, he's just this terrible, recently graduated alcoholic who's with this girl. Temple, Fast Girl, as she's called. And putting her in a lot of trouble, a lot of trouble around these other men who are harassing her, this poor girl. Even the woman that she's around is like, nobody. Anyway, she's supposed to leave by midnight, and, that would be best for her. Yeah, I don't know what to say. Like, in a way, it is one of the easiest books I've read by Faulkner, but I read most of it today, and today is the day that I was dealing with my appeal to get my channel undeleted, and so that was on my mind. So I might actually have to go through the first eight chapters again. I know. Yeah, part of the problem is also, like, I was really distracted while reading it, but part of the problem is that I think, like, some of the action when it's happening, like, it's kind of boring and dry, but also it's a little unclear. Also, there's this character who talks with an accent, and no writer should ever do that unless it's very light. But this guy, oh my God, it's unreadable, just like William Faulkner. Oh wait, William Faulkner is the guy that wrote this. Yeah, anyway, Stevens and Temple have missed Temple's train, and he's looking for a drink, and this just leads down a rabbit hole of trouble and harassment, and it's not looking good. It's not looking good. It's not looking good. I'm probably going to go back over the first eight chapters, just quickly to skim through it. Now that I know my channel is back, so that I can make sure that I do have a stronger understanding of what happened. I was really distracted while reading. But also, I feel like the writing in this, I think it's because it's his third book, still a bit early in his career. I feel like it's actually really confusing because he hasn't found himself in a way. But even when he finds himself later, it's just going to be confusing because he thinks he can do it, and he's going to do it deliberately. And I don't have fun reading Faulkner, and I feel a foreboding sense of horror while I read this, and I can only imagine how much worse it's gonna get, because these characters, I mean, Benbow just seems troubling. Popeye is horrifying. I mean, that guy scares me. Okay, the woman he is around also scares me. Stevens just Temple is, by the way, the daughter of a judge in Jackson, and she's got these four brothers, and they're all in different positions, or studying to be in some really good positions, and I'm hesitant to say that I'm looking forward to reading the rest of the book. I'm not as distracted now, so it should be easier for me to retain some information, but also I'm a little bit worried for this girl, because it's not looking good, and I can only, nothing good can happen. Everything I've read so far and retained is just bad things are going to happen, and I don't know if I want to read that, because I was just in a bad mood for weeks, got in a good mood, lost that good mood for 8 hours, and now I'm in a good mood again, and now I'm reading this book, and actually I'm going to read it. I'm not looking forward to it, but we'll see. I'm not enjoying the characters as much. I mean, not so much because they're so low down and dirty and terrible, but they're perfectly fine so far. I imagine they will become more complex as the story goes on, but I'm missing the complexity that felt a lot more immediate in Absalom, and and Go Down Moses. In this book, it just kind of feels like I'm watching a train wreck in slow motion, and I can't do anything about it. And unfortunately, Temple is tied to the train tracks. Anyway, thank you.